burning.
And I'll be right with you.
That's what they always say. They always end up with their flesh torn to pieces.
Which is a real good reason to stop distracting me.
That thou knowest in this cavern, rest assured of that. The being that lives here wishes to take over this body.
Huh. You mean my body?
A pity that thou art not as combative with it. It is consuming thy mind e'en now, and yet thou dost offer no resistance. If thou dost allow it to continue, thou wilt be erased. replaced. And that is not in my best interests either.
Now that's ironic. Isn't that what you're doing to me?
An insulting comparison. This parasite is nothing. It is insignificant. I can easily protect us, if thou dost allow it. Thou shouldst give me more space, more liberty, open thy mind instead of keeping me prisoner.
Yeah, we'll see. You're asking me to let you come in and mark out your territory, but at what price?
Thou wilt gain access to a greater part of me, to my knowledge, to my power. All that thou riskest is to gain in knowledge and power, and that can do thee no harm. We shall only be stronger, both of us.
Well, let's see. Everything is rosy and without a care.
I imagine that thou wouldst undergo a slight physical transformation. Thy body was not conceived to contain a power such as mine. It will consume thee if thou refuseth to evolve.
There we go. Admit it. You feel better.
Whatever thou risketh in trusting me is insignificant in comparison with what awaits us if thou dost stay and do nothing. If thou dost refuse to evolve, we will both soon be lost, and this world will follow.
Right, all right. Between the non-stop screaming and all your moaning, my head is going to explode anyway. So go ahead and do it.
Wise decision. Thou wilt not regret it. Now, thou must empty out all of thy thoughts. Allow me to move. Yes. At last I can move. Breathe. Think freely. Thou mayest continue. If anything tries to control thy mind, I will make certain they understand who is in command.
Damn, this place is giving me the shivers. At least there's nobody here to give a shit if I crap my pants.
If thou art incapable of controlling thy body, thou mayest as well let me do it.
Don't push me. Village. Now that I see why you'd rather not show up in person. Oh yeah, I don't hear your voice in my head. You must have heard that out, right? So if you've got a message to deliver, you're gonna have to do it the old-fashioned way. Forget it. I came down here to do two things. Look for mushrooms and kick somebody's ass. And guess what? I ain't found any mushrooms.
Well, your Ice Lords have never messed with a Powder Master, now have they?
If you listen to the rabble who actually live in the swamps, we should head back to the village now. If he was right, and a general is directing the attack, only your power could stop them.
On the move again, and he's not wasting any time.
The puppet he confronts, it is not like the others.
It's more likely to be the Puppet Master. He looks like a Deadwalker general. He's probably leading the assault on Valvanor.
All of this power he animates with, it belongs to me. It was stolen and twisted by your miserable magicians. It is time to take back what is mine by right.
If you're planning to take care of him like all the others, sounds good to me. Prince Arundel won't last long facing that kind of monster.
He's using more power than thou wilt allow me to deploy.
I can take care of myself, and here's my plan. I'm gonna come at him with everything I've got. Killing their general is gonna screw up our enemies big time. Let's go do it.
Thank you.
him, but he seems to want to take revenge personally.
That was one tough death's head, but it won't command anyone now. Without their general, the Dead Walkers should leave us alone for a while. But they'll reorganize, so we can't stay
here. There you are, at last.
We will go together to Karathas, but once there our paths must part. I have to find the World Heart and purify it.
I hope that you will change your mind on the way. We will need you.
No fleshly vessel has ever been able to master it.
Yes. See what good it did them? Now that I am revealed, the sorcerers will covet this power.
As do thy supposed allies. Thou shouldst beware of them and their weakness. Let nothing stop thee from preserving thyself lest we finish, as did the dragons.
Perhaps it is time I took things in hand.
Vulcan? Have you seen something?
They use thee.
Vulcan, your captain will be wondering where we are.
Huh? Yes, of course. Let's go.
There you are, sire. Right. Change of plan. Seeing how cold it is, it will come as no surprise to you to learn that the Dead Walkers have already been here. They're still close.
We must rejoin my father's army as swiftly as we may.
I think we already found them. Take a look around us.
There are survivors. Apparently, they are camped not far from here. This soldier will lead us to them.
Prince Arundel, my lord, can it be you?
Soldier, what happened here? Is the king with you?
The Dead Walkers took us by surprise. The cold and the ice. We stood no chance. Almost all of the city has been invaded by the ice.
My father, where is the king?
I know not, Your Highness. But a few of us were able to escape. Lord Commander Valen has built a camp close by the city.
Valen is here. Take us to his camp.
By your leave. Follow me, my lord.
You, Vulcan. I must save our king, with or without your aid. What is this thing?
I don't know, but it doesn't look right.
Son? My boy? Can it be you?
Oh, fuck.
By all the gods. Father? It cannot be!
Do not look upon me. I am so sorry. Do not stay here. Take the crown and leave this place.
Oh, Father. But what have they done to you?
I surrendered. Lord Blackfrost told me that he was slain. But Marshal Winter's army had left no survivors at Bastion. I had not the strength to even raise my sword. And so he changed us. Remade us, the other nobles and I. And all those who had taken refuge in the palace. He wanted me to witness our end. So that I would live without defeat. And news of your death for eternity. But you are alive. You live. Your mother and I are so relieved to know you live.
Mother? But how can I release you from this curse?
My son, if you only knew how sorry we are. You cannot save us. We are condemned to this abomination. You must slay us. The others, the Queen, the Count, all of these people. I feel their suffering. Hear their screams within me. Put an end to it, I beg you. Free us that our souls may be with you.
Sire, I can take care of this if you want me to.
For pity, my boy. Whatever you decide, take the crown.
There is more power lying hid in this twisted corpse than in a dozen juggernauts. I will not stand by and watch those blood-sucking necromancers steal it from me once more.
Sire, please step aside.
That is my father, the King of Karalthas. I have to perform the funeral rite to free his soul. Have you no respect?
Respect for him that joineth with the Deadwalkers? Ha! I think not.
We have to get back to the camp before the Deadwalkers come for us. The death of one of the liches is bound to have gotten their attention.
I will come soon. I must first perform a ritual to free my father's soul from this unholy carcass so that it may stay with me.
I'll wait outside. Can't afford to wait for Arundel. Not in his condition. The Deadwalkers will be scouring the city to find who killed their lich. We gotta get back to the camp fast.
Dost thou feel the power of the World Heart flowing through us since thou didst absorb the lich?
I feel a little stronger. But it's not enough.
Yes, it is far from over. This power comes straight from the necromancers, who sucked it from the World Heart. We must starve them.
We're not alone. What the hell is that thing with all those legs?
It is a concubine. Lord Blackfrost has always had somewhat unusual erotic tastes. Why would she be here, unless she already knows of our plan?
Curse them! Look at the support pillars. They crawl with Deadwalkers.
A trap, and a good one. Your little friends will be taken from the rear, if you'll pardon the expression.
We must prevent it. We have to hurry to open the drawbridge.
I say we must not. This concubine has given us an opportunity. We must attack her while her troops are busy elsewhere. These are creatures of great power. You must absorb them one by one if you hope to stand against Lord Blackfrost. Those other men are already as good as lost.
Do not heed the words of this witch! If you do not open the bridge, all our soldiers will die and this war will be over. I do not believe you even have need of this misshapen beast's supposed power. This evil whore is twisting your mind. She wishes to weaken us. From the beginning, she has been hiding something from us, and it will go ill for you if you trust her.
Really? I would have hoped for a little more affection from someone who spies on me when I bathe.
Edwin is right. There's nothing we could do to save those elves. Whereas we may never get another chance to attack an unprotected concubine.
Why, you traitor! I know not if this is your idea or that demon in you, but you are worth no more than this dead living scum!
Calm yourself, Relmar. Open your eyes. This is our only chance.
Shut your mouth, witch! It is you that has turned his head, and I shall hold you to account for every one of my lost brothers.
Thank you.
So, did I lie?
Not this time, wench.
Surprise me to find you behind all this.
My Lord Blackfrost.
I'm happy to see you have survived your exile. I knew you would come to appreciate the real value of your chance to rediscover a simple life. The life of an ordinary human. And, oh, what a charming dress. Completely your style. It suits you wonderfully.
I know. You, however, do not look quite so well. Why the mask?
Oh, you know, there was a sort of sudden power cut. As though someone had siphoned off the remaining fire from the world heart. It left a few marks. Our poor Crystal is particularly upset. But I imagine you know all about that, my dear White Lady. Oh, I'm sorry, it's just white now, isn't it?
Know about what? That the whore Crystal is upset? Truly, I did not know, but I confess the news delights me. Be assured, this is just the beginning, my dear, dear traitor. You will soon be much sadder than she is.
Ah, women. So ungrateful. I would have been so much wiser to make you into one of my concubines. But, hey, it's never too late. You owe me one, after all. And I have missed you so much.
Hey, I hate to interrupt your two-hour romantic reunion, but I'm losing the will to live over here. I didn't become a mercenary so I could listen to a lover's quarrel.
You little upstart. Nonetheless, you just aren't in the same class as a Lord of the Frozen Shadows. It wouldn't be sporting of me to eliminate you so early in the day. But you do have potential. I will leave you a little time to build your strength. When you think you're ready to face me, come to my domain. We will finish this once and for all. Oh, if you need directions, ask your charming friend. She knows the place well.
I suppose that could have gone even worse.
Yes, he could have slain you with ease, if that's what you mean.
And turned you into a zombie sex toy. Why do you think he didn't do it?
Indeed, it is troubling. We must believe he is interested in you. I imagine he seeks a way to seize the power that drives you. Doubtless he hopes to use it to rule the other Ice Lords, or destroy them.
After all, that's what you do, right, my White Lady? Or maybe that's what you've been planning ever since we met.
I have nothing to do with them. You heard what he said. They exiled me, cast me out, unprotected, into the wild, after having stripped me of all my powers.
All the more reason to try and get mine.
Don't be so foolish. If I was able to do such a thing, I would have done it long ago.
Great. That's reassuring.
Take it as you please. But you are my only hope of taking revenge on the Ice Lords, even if it's not by my hand. We're on the same side.
We'll talk about it later. We shouldn't hang around here. Any idea where Relmar went?
Probably gone to be with his own kind, what few still breathe.
Huh. I guess he felt that leaving his brothers was a betrayal.
In any case, it would be better for us to avoid meeting any elves on the way back to the camp. That fool has probably told them all his version.
We'll gather up the blades and get out of this place. There's nothing left for us here at Karalthas.
Thou drawest near. I do feel it.
Is his trap.
The necromancer craves our power for himself alone. He will not have warned the others of our approach. His trap and his greed will be his undoing.
I'm still not powerful enough.
But thou wilt so become. The domain is peopled by superior creatures that are bathed in the energy of the world heart. Our energy. Once there, thou wilt know what to do. But be swift. I cannot long endure. Thou must concentrate upon these creatures, and waste not thy time with the others.
I will return to the world heart when I'm ready. This necromancer is an obstacle that cannot be ignored.
No! I have had enough of this prison, of this sacrilege, of this servitude! How dare thee leave me thus! Thou art no better than they!
Wake up, Vulcan. This is not the moment.
All this energy, everywhere. We draw near our goal.
A concubine!
The Stalker!
Favorite traitor. So happy to see you again, Vulcan. You certainly took your time getting here.
Well, Mara, Prince Heyerdahl. I was sure the Deadwalkers got you both at Karalthas.
Yes, luckily for us, we weren't depending on you to get us out of there. Unlike all of those elves that you left to die.
I didn't have a choice. I had to get here as fast as possible. I need to get into the world heart.
You did have a choice, and you chose for the worst. You sacrificed my people and even your own brother mercenaries. How could you have allowed it?
That battle was already lost, and you knew it perfectly well. So spare me your saliva, sire.
You could have been the difference. If only you had wanted to. Look at you. You're no longer even human. You've become this thing.
We can't let you get away with it. For the memory of our brothers, for Vertil, we must stop you.
You're out of your mind.
Yeah!
Such a waste.
She was a tough one, Now I can see what Black Frost saw in her. Spunky. To me.
In your dreams, I am Lord Blackfrost's number one concubine. I belong to no one but him.
I will present him with my insectoid carcass after I have picked my teeth with thy dainty feet. It is thy power that doth interest me, my power, that which thy master hath stolen from me.
You think you will defeat because you bested my daughters? I should thank you for getting rid of those harlots by offering you a quick and paying stay. But unfortunately for you, my Lord Blackfrost has other plans where you are concerned.
Come on.
are about to actually penetrate the realm of Lord Blackfrost. But do not fool yourself. You did not win your passage alone. It was the evil Lord himself who opened the way inside.
He's testing me.
Yes. And it would have... This should be one of the most fascinating...
Yeah. Well, I can... See that you've made some real progress. Yes, yes, you have.
Yeah, well, your concubines won't be progressing anywhere ever. From now on your own, and there's no escape.
Well, that was never my intention. I'm in my realm here. You and your companions are my guests. Oh, it seems that you too have lost some friends along the way. How very sad. More than most, I know how fragile a friendly alliance can be. Isn't that so, White Lady? Yet it seems destiny has reunited us once again. Oh, what a delicious irony.
I'll be savoring the delicious irony of your protégé humiliating and destroying you right before my eyes. Now you know why I'm here.
My dear lady, it is useless to lie to me, and you know it. You are here because you want the same thing I do. For the moment, you do not have the power, but I know that you will leap for it at the slightest opportunity. I have missed you, Yuna. Once I have extracted what interests me from the corpse of your friend, I will make you my new number one concubine. But don't you worry. Crystal and the Ice Duchess will be joining you very soon. Not even Black Storm will dare to oppose me now.
Look, I've about had it with both of you monsters. Blackfrost, sorry, but the time has come for me to shut you up for good.
And it is I who will extract what belongs to me from thy dead carcass.
Thank you.
In 6,000 years of existence, I don't think I've ever had a day quite as interesting as this one. Vulcan, my dear, this was a fight that deserves to be included in the history books. You may count on me to tell future generations.
That affairs me not. I must return to the World Heart.
Clearly. And that is each Ice Lord possesses the means to gain access to the World Heart from his or her own power. I would have loved to accompany you. The World Heart obeys neither the same rules nor the same magic.
I have need of no one.
Fine.
Didst thou e'en take time to think? I did not lie to thee. I had no choice. I had to seize this chance to escape and find a way to fight back, lest we be enslaved here for all eternity. Eternity? Dost thou know how slow the hours pass when thou art the prey of six humans, consumed by their lust for power and vengeance? I know this as well as thee. Thou dost not. Thou knowest nothing. I too made use of the confusion. I riposted. I struck back at them, weakened them. But thou hast abandoned me to them. But now I am returned. And together, we will crush them. Is't true? Thou art returned.
State that you left her in, Aelos. Cleavage and all.
You are weak and stupid. She was able to manipulate you, and you didn't even try to resist her. You weren't even able to keep safe those few who begged you for help. How can you possibly believe you have what it takes to save all of Vertiel from the Ice Lords?
You should have saved the Red Scribes! Traitor! You were supposed to protect us! That was your contract!
The company could have been yours, but you preferred to take it by force. Condemn the freeborn blasphemy of the
Run away, Cloudant!
Never think of anybody else. The Knight fights for the survival of the human.
I thank you, monster. Without you, I would never have been able to kill this whore of a traitor.
Thank you.
that thou wouldst allow these humans to corrupt thee.
A dragon? You summoned a dragon?
Huh. One of the few they were able to corrupt, and I turned it against them. Blackstorm defeated it and imprisoned it here. It was trapped. Like me.
So now you turned it against me?
It is thee who has turned against me. Abandoning me here, left to pay the price for each and all of thy errors in thy stead, whilst I did all I could to help thee to return. And so it is, I am come to the end of my strength. An empty shell o'ertaken with rot. I did not wish to harm thee, but I no longer am master of all that I do.
Is that why you killed my companions?
The visions? Blame rather thy human half. For that is who hath invoked them, with its fear and its regrets. Thy companions never traveled through the breach.
So it comes to this. You and me. It's time we ended this.
Ha! It is all I have awaited. Remove these accursed lances from me, and let the world heart become whole once more.
Here we are, the world heart. I'm guessing that this is not the first time you've been here.
Your guess is right.
What should I do about these spears, or the demon?
Pull out the spears and the Ice Lords lose all of their powers. On the other hand, nothing says you have to pull them out. The White Lady could rule over Vertiol with you at her side.
We're here, Ranval. This...
The heart of the one who is just. When faced with the ultimate choice, the life of the knight has been spared by his friend. Now it is the...
So this is what the world hoped.
Yes. Terrible. And
I just hope that in spite of everything, you're not, because I have absolutely no...
Faced with any kind of choice, it is impossible to be sure of making the right decision. But what I can tell you is that the entity within you is a piece, a limb. By sending part of itself to Vertiel to inhabit a living body, it knew it would be protected. But while it was incarnate, the demon saw what we have done to the world. What terrible... Alas, I fear that now it wants to destroy everything. Wipe the faith. You came to rescue me, even though it meant risking failure. I know you will do all that is in your power. This world must be rid of the Ice Lords, but beware of letting the demon return to the heart. He will destroy all who live. It will take us longer to rebuild.
Necromancers will be the first into the fire. I have traveled this world and lived amongst its peoples, its elves, its humans, and I have witnessed the truth of their ilk. Vanquishing the necromancers will not suffice for them. Others will return to enslave the power of the world heart once more. There is but one remedy. One sentence that must be passed.
No. They will have learned their lesson. They'll be able to make a fresh start.
Their world must be destroyed with flame.
Please, give them a chance. Think of those who helped us. Cannot condemn all of humanity.
In what way is that of concern to us? We are no longer human. Flame will burn bright anew.
that far. All we need is to remove these spears, and the necromancers will be left powerless.
As powerless as when they enslaved the World Heart? No, it will not suffice. They must be annihilated.
I'll track them down. The Deadwalkers will be gone. The survivors will have a chance, and Vertiel will be rebuilt, little by little.
Little by little? It would take centuries, nay thousands of years, for thy world to rebuild its energy. The World Heart have not been remade whole. Thou must permit me to rejoin with mine other half.
So that you can take over and burn Vertiel? No thanks. I am the most powerful being in the two worlds. I have got responsibilities.
Thou wouldst use me to reign over them, as did the necromancers. How long dost thou imagine that I shall allow thee to use me in this way?
I don't know, but you better get used to it. You were the one talking about centuries and thousands of years before our worlds can be rebuilt. And I plan on being right there to keep an eye on them. Meanwhile, do me a favor and let me enjoy this victory in silence. Do you mind?